In this case study, we will be creating this honeycomb pattern, which gradually fades into nothing and flushes with the surrounding face. Take note that I'm only going to focus on creating the honeycomb pattern and not the whole cover. To speed up the patterning process and the features associated with it, I will be demonstrating with a pattern that is less dense than what is shown here. Let's create the base sketch on the top plane. This will be a rectangle centered on the origin. Begin the extrude command. And extrude downwards. With that, this face is in line with the top plane. Hide the base body for the moment. We will start a sketch on the top plane for the honeycomb. Let's create a hexagon centered on the origin. Go to create. Polygon. Circumscribe polygon. Set a vertical constraint on this edge. Draw a line from the center to the midpoint of this edge. Draw another line from the center to the midpoint of the adjacent edge. Convert both lines into construction. These will serve as directions during the patterning process. I personally try to avoid doing patterns within sketches as I like to keep them simple. My plan is to use this sketch to produce a thin extrude. After that, I will perform a rectangular pattern of bodies. Start the extrude command and select the thin extrude option. We want to extrude this slightly below the top plane. To do that, go to the Start option and select Offset. Set an offset of -1 mm. I will explain later why we need this offset. Adjust the distance. And wall thickness. In this case, I will set the wall location to side 1 so that it thickens inwards from the profile. Go to Create, Pattern, Rectangular Pattern. For type, select Bodies, and select the body. For directions, click on the select box. Bring back the honeycomb sketch. And select the two construction lines. For distance type, set to spacing. For both direction type, set to symmetric. Adjust the quantity and distance. I have adjusted the spacing in a way that causes the bodies to exactly overlap with each other so that we can maintain the same wall thickness throughout. Unfortunately, there is no option to join all these bodies within the pattern command. Let's bring back the base body to take a look at where the pattern is relative to it. In your own designs, you should adjust the pattern according to where you need it to be. Hide the base body. Now would be a good time to save. Box select all the honeycomb bodies. Go to Modify, Combine. Set the operation to join and combine all these bodies into one. Let's bring back the base body to take a look and compare it with the finished model. Looking at the finished model, if you observe the honeycomb pattern from the side, it sort of rises up and down like a wave. We shall use a spline to define this profile. Notice also that the pattern is at a 45 degree angle from the horizontal. Go to Construct, Plane at Angle. Select the Y axis. and adjust the angle to minus 45. Start a sketch on this plane. Draw a horizontal line. Control select the endpoint and the origin, and add a horizontal constraint. Draw a vertical line from the origin. And convert it to a center line. Begin the mirror command. The center line is automatically highlighted as a mirror line. Select the horizontal line as the object to mirror. These three points will form the scaffold for the spline. Begin a fit point spline and snap to these three points. Click on the horizontal vertical constraint and click on the center spline handle to make it horizontal. Click on the spline to review the two spline handles at the sides. Adjust each spline handle slightly until they turn blue. In my experience, I find that this reduces the possibility of the spline warping when you impose a symmetry constraint. Begin the symmetry constraint and select the endpoint of this spline handle. When you hover the cursor over that point, it should turn white. Click on that point. Do the same for the other spline handle. Lastly, select the center line. With this, both the angle and length of both spline handles will be mirrored across the center line. Add a tangent constraint between a spline and a straight line on one side. This will be mirrored also. Dimension the spline handles. And dimension the height of the center line. Confirm the sketch. And bring back the honeycomb. When you are doing this sketch, the overall sketch should exceed the extent of the honeycomb pattern. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Extrude. Select the sketch as a profile. And create a symmetrical extruded surface. Adjust the distance until it covers the honeycomb pattern completely. Hide this surface body for the moment. Activate the Solid tab. Select the top face of the honeycomb pattern and begin the Extrude command. Let's bring back the surface body and look normal to the sketch plane on which the spline was created. We want to extrude up to the surface body. Remember earlier that the honeycomb was extruded with an offset from the top plane. Without that offset, the Extrude 2 object would fail, as you will be asking the command to extrude a zero thickness solid in the areas on either side of the spline. So this is why we needed that offset. For extent type, set to 2 object. From the bodies folder, select the surface body as the object. This surface body will act as a limiting surface for the extrude. Let's confirm and hide a surface body. Bring back the base body. Let's use the side walls of the base body to trim off the excess. Go to Modify, Split Body. Select the honeycomb as a body to split. For splitting tool, click on the Select box and select this side wall. If you hover the cursor near an edge, you can see the whole body getting highlighted. If you click at this point, it will be selecting the whole body as a spitting tool, which is not what we want. I would advise you to zoom in and make sure that you hover the cursor directly over the face. Make sure that only the face is highlighted before selecting. We can select multiple faces as spitting tools. To fully cut through the body, we need to extend. Control select the two excess bodies, right click and remove. You can see that the honeycomb pattern on either side of the spline flushes with the base body. However, since it is still a separate body, you can see these edges. We need to combine these two bodies. Go to Modify, Combine. And combine the honeycomb and the base body. When the combine is done, the effect does not look that impressive due to the visibility of the tangent edges. It will look better with the shader view turned on. Or you can go into the render workspace. The transition effect should also look better with a denser honeycomb pattern.